decided to keep the name Black Sabbath, even though you're the only original member, Tony, and you have a brand new album. You've left Warner Brothers. Currently, you're on IRS Records. The album is called Headless Cross. You've also kept the musical ideas of Black Sabbath. Why?
Well, I don't see why not. I was there from day one, and everybody else has come and gone and come back and gone again. And I'm the only one that stayed there. And I think now it deserves to be Black Sabbath more than anything, particularly with people like Cozy in the band, who we've known for since before Black Sabbath. And, you know, to have such a great drummer as Cozy, I think he deserves to be kept to that sort of name as Black Sabbath. And we're portraying the band as it should be now.
Changes that Black Sabbath has gone through, Tony. Which band was your favorite?
Up until now, you mean?
Yeah.
I quite like the Ronnie period from Heaven and Hell. Man, that period was good.
Live Evil.
Yeah, well, from the Heaven and Hell album, yeah. Obviously I like the old stuff, but I think it was a lot more organized from 1980 onwards.
In the decline of Western civilization, the heavy metal years, Ozzy Osbourne said that things got quite out of control in the early North American tours for Black Sabbath, almost like you were viewing yourself as an outsider, just taking a look in on this thing called Black Sabbath.
Well, I don't think it ever got out of control. I mean, it sort of took off pretty quick, really. I mean, when we came, well, the album was out for, it was in the charts for 18 months before we came here, so it was doing quite well. So when we first came here, it was a bit of a shock to sort of come right into these sort of venues, you know.
Live Aid, have people been trying to get Black Sabbath back together for a reunion?
We had it before Live Aid. In fact, we seriously thought about it before the Live Aid. Realized when we'd done the Live Aid that it wouldn't work. And it just wouldn't. It just, you know, just doesn't click.
A lot of dummies getting money just for clapping their hands. Got the fire, all the fire of a
people are covering Black Sabbath material these days, and a lot of rappers are sampling Black Sabbath and sometimes using the whole track. Most notably so, Ice-T and Sir Mix-a-Lot, with the help of Metal Church, have come out with the track Iron Man, which is your Iron Man. How do you feel about the sampling and rappers using your material in a different way than it was intended?
We're sampling a lot of rap records now on our album.
Yeah.
not that much for gadgetry and stuff. I mean, I suppose it's good to know, I suppose, that people are finally noticing that we are around, and we're not going to go away, so they're starting to cover our stuff. And in fact, there's a lot of bands now that's covering Sabbath material. Quite a lot. We last time we were in America, we done a commercial tour of Cozy and myself, and one of the chaps we done an interview with gave us four or five or six cassettes of different groups that's, you know, covered Sabbath stuff. We had a listen on the plane back.
It was hilarious, wasn't it?
Quite funny, really. Quite funny to hear somebody else doing your stuff. And it's, you know, it's a nice form of flattery, I suppose.
Heavy rock and roll, or just rock and roll. There was no heavy metal, and there wasn't a whole industry around heavy metal like it is now. And you guys being sort of the godfathers of the heavy metal scene, along with other people like Jimmy Page and the whole Led Zeppelin thing, how do you feel about this industry that has sprung up, which is now called heavy metal?
Well, we've never really used that term anyway, and heavy metal can be anything from Bon Jovi now. I just don't know what, you know, where you put it in, what category you put it in, and heavy rock and stuff. I mean, so many bands have been called heavy rock that are not even remotely concerned with it, any kind of heavy stuff. I think it's just gone up in the air. I don't think people can define what's like heavy rock and what's middle of the road now. I don't particularly like the term heavy metal, but it's sort of, as you say, it's gone around in one big circle.
It's just the sort of the name of the music is marketed into a certain bracket. Everybody wants to put you into a pigeonhole, and you play this stuff and you play that stuff. All we do is just play what we like to write. I mean, people are going to call it all kinds of things, but I don't see a lot of resemblance from bands today of what we were doing when we first started at all, to be honest with you. And the stuff that is being done now is just a sort of a copy of it, or they're just rearranging the stuff. The trouble is with these days, it seems to be the image is more important than the music.
Yeah.
Everybody looks like they're in a band, and most of the kids can't play.
And if they haven't got any airspray and died of their plant, they're lost.
It's sort of got a bit farcical, I think. There's no musicianship anymore. It's just if you look good and you can pose about, then you're in the band, and that's it.
Cross. Now, you know you're still going to get the satanic rap.
A lot of the Sabbath stuff's been taken the wrong way in majority of times, because they're all about, all the songs and stuff are about either dreams or things that can happen or do happen. In life, in general, it's just about life, really. And everybody seems to say it's black magic and whatever, you know, it's just taken wrong. If they was to listen to the words properly or read the words, I'd see really what it is about.
See that each song actually is almost like a mini movie.
Well, yeah, it's a little story, yeah. And that's, you know, some of them are true stories. As I say, Headless Cross is a true story. It's about a village in the 16th century that was had a plague there, and they erected a cross in the centre of the village and turned to the cross to pray to try and remove the plague. And of course it didn't, and they all died, and the cross is still there, and they called the village Headless Cross. And so we took the idea of that to call it into the song and the album cover.
It begins tomorrow night in Portland, Maine. Last time through, the band resembled more like something out of Spinal Tap rather than the fathers of heavy metal. This time round, though, the group appears to be on a far more solid footing. Alongside founding member Tony Iommi will be Cozy Powell on drums and also the Whitesnake bassist Neil Murray. Only one Canadian date has been announced so far. It is in Toronto, June the 12th, at the Varsity Arena. It's all in support of their latest album. Fritz Meyer of CNN News reports.
They are often called the grandfathers of heavy metal, a title that they find a little extreme. But after 21 years of rock and roll and an endless number of followers and copiers, what would one expect?
And I think it's nice that people still listen to Sabbath, and still some of the younger bands actually copy the tunes and are very much influenced by his music. So it's interesting to see that so many groups today are doing Sabbath material and doing that kind of stuff.
The sound has remained the same, but the faces have changed quite a few times. The most publicized change for the band was when Ozzy Osbourne left to go solo. While most people saw this as the end of Black Sabbath, the band saw it as a new beginning.
It made a tremendous difference to the band, to the overall feeling of the band as well. Because obviously with Ozzy, we'd gone through that many stages and we got to such a low then. We didn't know if he was coming or going half the time. And so when Ronnie came in, it was quite a lift.
I mean, you are under a lot of pressure all the time to deliver this, and touring schedules are pretty chaotic. I don't think a lot of people realise just how chaotic they are. And the egos within members of bands has always been the stumbling block. You may get four or five individuals that play great, but they just can't get on the road because you're living on top of each other for 15, 16 hours a day.
Black Sabbath feels they've finally got the right combination and that it shows in their music.
Obviously the sound is going to stay very much the same sound it's been for years because of Tony's guitar presence, but everybody else can add to it, and we've just managed to get the production to be a little better this time. It's a lot more powerful than it's been for the last two or three years, and I think all in all it's very much a Sabbath album in a Sabbath mould, but it's got the 90s feel about it.